country is passing through a serious economic slowdown, and it is not typical to our own country alone. It is now a global phenomenon. Throughout the world, this system is going on. A serious recession is coming on the entire global economy, and our country is a part of it, number one. Number two, this recession is coming because of the neoliberal operation of the entire capitalist system, which basically suppresses the earning of the people who are creating value in the society, who are creating GDP. They suppress their earning. And because of that, low purchasing power of the people, the market of commodity is getting smaller and smaller. And it directly affects the capacity utilization of the industries who are producing different commodities. They produce, but that cannot be sold. Next step will be they will reduce their production. And at one point of time, they will close their factory and go. That is what is happening in our country. Entire automobile sector slowed down. Around 1.5 million people lost their job. And over and above, around 1.5 million have lost their earning. Weekly, 3 days, 4 days, shut down. It means the workers, particularly contract workers, are not getting any wages for three to four days in a particular week. Only in Ashok Leyland, in all his four plants, in 1 month, total number of shutdown days is 59 days. All the four plants together. Total 59 days. It means workers there lost their wages in 1 month, 59 days. 1 month is a 60 day. Not that they got 1 day wage, but I'm telling you, all the four plants, if you add together the number of weekly shutdown days, it comes 59 days in a month. This is the depth of the crisis, because of this, the more the pressure of the workers, and they are losing their wage, means they are going out of the market. They are not purchasing cycles, they are not purchasing clothes, they are not purchasing other industrial commodities. And accordingly, the market gets squeezed, and ultimately factory stops production. They are facing a situation of overproduction, and finally they stop production. This is the basic reason of the crisis, not only in our country, but all over the world. All over the world. Now, what is the outcome of that? How do you want to come out of it? It is only coming out, is only the way that you have to increase the purchasing power of the consumers. That is the common people. Without that, you cannot, there cannot be any other way. You want more investment to come, but what is happening last 5-6 years, continuously investment is going down in our country. Investment that generates employment. Investment in share market, which is nothing but gambling, that does not generate employment. If I earn in share market investment, I get, say, some 1,000 rupees, it means somebody else's pocket 1,000 rupees has gone up. That's how, in a gambling, a person, when he earns, somebody loses. No new value is created. Value is created only through improper process, in the production process, in the service process. That is the basic economy. Nobody can challenge it. Neither Nirmala Sitharaman nor his prime minister. But this process, instead of going into them, what they are doing, they are trying to incentivize the investment. What has happened in the budget? In the first budget, they have given around 2 lakh crore concession after the new government. On 5th July, the budget they have done. They have reduced the corporate tax from 35% to 25%. It is in July. In the month of August, rather end August, again Nirmala Sitharaman came with a package of 70,000 crore of rupees. They have reduced the surcharge. They have withdrawn the binding of CSR spending on the company and some other concessions for export and other. Value of that concession was 70,000 crore. Nothing happened. Rather, after that concession, situation has further deteriorated. Now, yesterday, they have given again a package. 1,55,000 crore. What they have done? From 25%, they have reduced the tax on profit to 22%. And also declared that from 1st October, any new manufacturing unit that will come, they have to pay 15% tax on profit if they start their production activity latest by 2023. New company need not pay tax immediately. They will can pay tax when they produce their sale, they earn profit on that day. Tax will be assessed on them. But in advance, 3 years in advance, they are making this announcement. That is, they are telling their fathers in the corporate council that, well, I have reduced from 35 to 25. 25 to 22, and finally we are going to reduce it to 15. You go on paying me your electoral bonds to me. In the last election, BJP got 98% of the electoral bonds contribution from different corporate houses. 98%. How told? They told that they are giving a message. Let the country go to hell. But I should continue to get the electoral bond contribution. So we have reduced from 35 to 25, 25 to 22. Now we will reduce further into 15. But these foolish people, they are forgetting that if this slowdown continues, the profit will also come down. Then on what they have to get tax? Factories will close down. Business will shut down. If this situation continues, and if this situation is not addressed, now all the trade union, what they are demanding? The trade union's demand are alternative policy to come bring the country out of this dangerous business. If the problem is that market is squeezing, effective demand is not generating in the market. And that does not mean people don't have demand. People are hungry. The highest number of hungry people are in our country. It is the World Health Organization. But they don't have money to purchase. They don't have money to purchase. They are halfway. They could not get their children treated. You see the dropout in schools are increasing every day. So, and if dropout in school increases, the demand for paper will go down. Books will not be printed. Because people consuming books will also go down. So, what trade unions, all the trade unions, are jointly asking that you have to take action in addressing this situation so that the enough demand is generated in the market. That is, increase the minimum wage to 18,000. Make universal social security. Let everybody get a pension of 3,000 rupees. There must be public investment in agriculture so that agricultural irrigation cost in agriculture is come down. We are telling that the poor peasants, middle peasants, they are not getting loans from the banks. But they are not basically thieves. Corporates are basically thieves. They are taking 10,000, 20,000 crore loan from the bank and not paying back. But poor people, if you take money, they pay back. Maybe not tomorrow, but day after tomorrow, they will pay back. We are telling that these poor people must be brought under the institutional levy. In banks, in cooperatives, they should get loan so that they can cultivate, create value for themselves, so that with that they can go to market and purchase their clothes, cycles and other goods and services. A demand will be created in the markets, and to meet that demand, investors will run, come running to set up factories in our country. No investor can put money if he is not sure that I have 2,000 rupees in the market, I will be getting back at 1,025 rupees or 1,500 rupees. Unless investment return, and return cannot be guaranteed. If he produces and he cannot sell his material. Because people have no money in their heart. So basically these issues to be addressed, that is what trade unions are. There are 12 point demands, joint demand of all the trade unions are basically framed on this. That 18,000 rupees minimum wage, universal social security benefit, universal pension benefit, and no privatization. Because even if you are not having enough market, public sector continue to produce. Your fallen stimpant is targeted to be sold out. Modi government is telling it is earning loss, so we are even selling it out. But they are producing continuously, they are not stopped producing. And fallen stimpant producing means not only fallen workers are working, but attached to that different small-scale unit, they are also working. BHL, they are continuously producing and trying to get their orders. And BHL is working means attached to BHL Trichy, at least there are 100 small-scale units. They are also working. If BHL stops production and 100 small-scale units get closed down, then you can understand market demand will further go down. So public sector can keep the economy alive. So don't privatize. That is our meeting. There are mutual interests. Chinese commodities are sold in Indian market. And India also has an interest in Chinese market. It's a very big market. So there may be corporate talk of cooperation. If they really do it, it is welcome. What is wrong in it? That is not it. But again, whether it is China or any other country, we cannot allow our market to be exploited at the cost of our industry. If some material comes from there, which is harming our country's own industry and causing unemployment, government must take a very firm. It is from the trade unions. In the earlier Modi government, Arun Jaitley was the finance minister. This Nirmala Sitharaman was the commerce minister. We have made, compared in, at that time I was in the parliament, we raised the issue in the parliament, then we chased them along with the steel workers movement. We compelled this government to increase the import price on steel coming from China, Korea, Russia and Japan. Because these four countries, they are flooding our market with their steel at below cost. We compelled that our country's steel industry will get ruined if we don't do it. And we could compel it to increase the import tariff to the anti-dumping level for a period of 6 months. And our country industry, not only public sector, but also private sector steel industry got greatly. So we welcome any cooperation and things. If it is mutually beneficial, that is very clear. We have no inhibition, whether it is China or Russia or Vietnam or anybody. Our country's industries existence cannot be sacrificed, cannot be compromised. But what's happening in economic policy? This Modi government is betraying the national interest while talking about national. When they are entering into a deal to purchase aircraft from Rafael without a policy of provision of technology transfer, he is betraying national. Earlier, all big defense procurement have a technology transfer provision in there. That was the policy of the government. What happened when you have purchased big aircraft, Sukhoi aircraft from Russia? Big aircraft. First slot you have purchased, along with the technology transfer provision. And the second lot, our country, HAL, Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, is to produce. Whatever submarine we are purchasing from other countries, first lot we purchase. Second lot, our shipyard is to produce. Our Cochin shipyard, our Vizag shipyard, our Garden Ridge shipyard in Gujarat, Kandla shipyard. We have 7 shipyards. They used to produce the second lot onward because technology was transferred. But the Rafael deal, there is no technology transfer. So Anil Ambani has been made a partner to that. Who will make the window, he will make the seat with Dunlopillo of the aircraft. But more than that, he cannot. Even the day-to-day maintenance, it has to be done by the foreign company. So they have a permanent market, and our industry will get shut down. Our shipyard, this is a betrayal to nationality. Our relays are being privatized. Our relay production units are getting corporatized. Only strong ABB, from whom already this BJP government started purchasing locomotives, coaches and wagons. It was not required by the government to purchase from abroad, because we have 7 production units who are producing to its fullest capacity. Quite efficient. But they are paving the way for its privatization, and ultimately they will purchase. They will take over this company. They are allowed 100% FDI in coal, commercial mining of coal. Ultimately, our coal-bearing lands will go under foreign control. These all sectoral-level actions may convert into a national-level strike at appropriate time, sometimes winter session or little of the gap is to be maintained one after another. Chain of strike will convert into a national level strike. And in that way, we are trying to make people understand. Yeah.
Somebody of your own caste or own religion has taken away food from you. And somebody else from other religion is offering you some food.
You will start thinking, I am a Hindu or a Muslim or a Sikh or a Greek.
Now, if somebody becomes idiot, he has to pay the cost of idiocy. And that is how they played their role.
They are dividing people on religious line, on communal line, on caste line. And they are also befooling you. That country is in danger. Only he can save the country. By destroying our base, industrial base of the country, on defense production, on railway production, by destroying that, you will serving the foreign companies abroad, Dassault Aviation of France, Lockheed of USA, that company in Israel. This government, elected by our people, but serving them. And that's why they are articulating their policy so that our domestic industrial base is destroyed. He's working with that project. Trade unions are openly telling before the people.
But even if you feel that, okay, country is in danger, Modi alone can save, okay. Let God save you, I can tell you. So we are trying to bring the people to sense. Yeah, you have rightly pointed out that is a veritable danger. In sharing the people to a right kind of consciousness so that they can identify their real enemy. They are not deceived. They are not cheated. They are not confused. It is our task to make people understand through the process of struggle. And we are busy in that, and this conference is dealing all about that. How to carry on the struggle.